How's it going? Welcome to my channel. My name is Edwin Art. Today I'll be working on a time-lapse slash tutorial on a very famous oil painting titled The End of the Ball, one of my personal favorites. Now, my palette's very simple. Titanium white, burnt umber, lime yellow, yellow ochre, magenta, cadmium red, sap green, ultramarine blue, and ivory black. Very easy to follow along with, or even just sit back and enjoy the show. Now, first things first, I always start off with a rough sketch just to familiarize myself with the painting and of course to practice. When working with a face, I like to start from the darks, work my way up to the lights. That gives you a clear map on what to work with. If you follow those steps, you don't even have to be a great painter, just as long as you know what you're doing. You could probably paint a face in 3 strokes. Very simple. Now, regarding what I just said, I decided to ignore my own advice and start with the lights, which was a big mistake. But I pushed through it and it came out pretty good. Ended up with a pretty good looking lady. And that's never a bad thing. So normally, you start from the back of the painting and work your way up, but I just wanted to get the faces over with because it's a little more complicated, just so I can start working from the back. Right here, I'm gonna add a little candle, so I'm gonna lighten it up a little bit, and maybe add some reflection of the ground, just to show off that really warm candle lighting up the room. Now, there's also some very nice, beautiful teal wallpaper they use in this scene, and people probably smoked a lot back then, so you wanna add a little weathering to the wallpaper. Now, regarding that, it's still a very nice place. So they have some gold decorations to the wallpaper. Very nice. And you can see me lining it up. Now for the gold, I should use burnt umber, darkening it up. And some white to my lime yellow. Just give it those very nice accents and give it that nice gold color. Now for the foliage, I usually start off with some sap green and some red, just to darken it up. And just lighting up some places, add some flowers, nothing too fancy, not a lot of detail. We'll go over it later. That's how I start off my plants, my flowers, make it look very nice. Now moving on to the dress, which was probably my favorite part. It's kind of a peachy pink. And for the lower part of the dress, same thing as a face. You want to start off with the darks, work your way up to the lights. As long as you have everything in the right place, you can just blend it out and it'll look pretty nice. One thing I love about oil painting is you can blend almost anything, it'll look good. So I thought the original hand positioning was a little unnatural, so I moved it up, so instead of stretching out her hand, she's grabbing onto him, which I actually think looks a lot better. For his suit, it looks really dark, but all I used was burnt umber and some ultramarine blue. I don't like using ivory black on my paintings, it's just a little too dark for me, so I stick to the traditional burnt umber and ultramarine blue. So same thing as ivory black, I don't like using titanium white either. So again, I mix it with burnt umber and ultramarine blue. After I'm done filling in the gaps I left, I'm gonna add more detail to the foliage, which is just adding more darks, adding more lights, which is really all you need. Some more reds, some more purples, some more whites, and some more greens. This painting is almost finished. I'm just adding little details here and there, which surprisingly enough, take up the most time. The ending of the painting always takes more than the beginning. I decided to add some flowers. I don't have a correct way of painting flowers. What I like to do is I start off with light, paint a little white blob, and then I add some darks to it. I'm not sure if that's a correct way, but I like the way it looks. Believe it or not, I've been working on this painting since June. A little bit here and there, so I'm happy to finally be finished with it. Some minor details and it's all done. And of course you can't forget the little candle I mentioned in the very beginning. Nice little detail. And finally, we're all done. My recreation of the end of the ball. Thank you so much for tuning in and for staying for the whole video if you did. And remember, please leave a comment, like my video, and subscribe.